Yeah, today we are going to learn about age of industrialization. This is the last sub PPT, and it says market for goods. Now the Britishers set up the factories. They had goods. They produced goods. Now how did they market them? Okay, so markets for goods. We read about how a market was created for all the goods that were being produced by the British people. But each product that comes in market also needs to be sellable. That is, people must be convinced how it is worth buying. So how it is done? With the help of advertisement. So advertisement is one way of directly reaching the consumers. Ads seem to have been in vogue right from start of the industrial age. Vogue, trend, fashion. Okay, the meaning of vogue is trend. They have also always been in trend or in fashion. So you are also attracted towards the advertisement, isn't it? Like at your age, you see the Horlicks or Bourvita ad, and you ask your parents, like 1 or 2 year prior, you ask your parents to buy those products. Why? Because there is some small free thing with it, right? And you want that. So these are how, like, advertisement is a media and through which they say more about the product. They tell about how it is worth buying it. All the good things in it are being focused more in the advertisement, and that is what was done by the Britishers when they started bringing their products in the market. Labels were introduced by the Manchester industrialist too. Just reading Made in India or Made in China bring to mind various associations with regards to the quality, durability, etc. of the product. Now, durability, what does that mean? Yes, how long it will last? Its life? Yes, correct. Yeah, long lasting. Whether it is long lasting, good durability means long lasting, or its durability is less means it can broke up within a short limit of time. Okay, great. So the British played smart by adding images of Indian gods and goddesses on its label. Now, why this was done? As we know that the Manchester goods were banned. Okay, so you know the reason behind it. So now there was not a very good image of the British goods or the foreign goods in India. So they started using the Indian god and goddesses images so that the Indian people feel that it is an Indian product. So that was the marketing strategy used by the British. These pictures evoked a sense of familiarity despite it being foreign produced goods. So though they were produced by the foreigners, if they were foreign goods, they should feel that these pictures. Now at that time, not many people were literate to read, right? There were more people who were illiterate. So looking at the picture, they felt that this is Indian product. They felt a similarity or familiarity in them, and they used to buy that product. So that was a marketing strategy or a smart game played by the British. Calendars came into vogue too. Means like calendars also came into fashion after those. Like, since it could be used by even the illiterate, as I said priorly, so few products were used by any person, whether literate or illiterate. So the focus was more on the illiterate people because they were large in number at that time. Okay, people of national interest or nationality symbols were imprinted on products that were locally made. So now with this all, nationalism was also increasing, patriotism, the liking towards the nation, of like the fight for freedom was also going on side by side. Yes, national awareness was also going on. So now that what was interest, like what was in the interest of nation or nationality, those symbols were printed on the local गुड्स, लोकल मेड थिंग्स प्रोडक्ट्स, ओके। सिंबल्स, नेशनलिटी सिंबल्स मीन्स लाइक द ट्राई कलर, द चरखा और समथिंग, सम कॉमन थिंग्स और सम कॉमन पिक्चर्स, दोज आर द सिंबल्स ऑफ नेशनली, ओके। या फिर भारत माता, या दे हैव पिक्चराइज भारत माता, सो दोज पिक्चर्स वेर प्रिंटेड, येस, लाइक गांधी जी स्पेक्स ऑन विच मिशन, येस, स्वच्छ भारत, येस, करेक्ट। सो दैट इज अ सिंबल, राइट, नेशनल सिंबल वी कैन से, ओके। नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन, द मैसेज वॉज क्लियर, यूज इंडियन गुड्स इफ यू केयर फॉर द कंट्री। सो दिस वॉज ऑल डन नॉट ओनली टू गेन प्रॉफिट, नॉट ओनली टू स्टैंड डिफरेंटली, ओके, लाइक द फॉरन गुड्स, टू डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन द फॉरन गुड्स एंड द लोकल गुड्स, ओनली डिफरेंशिएशन वॉज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट, बट इनडायरेक्टली और डायरेक्टली द मैसेज वॉज गिवेन दैट यूज इंडियन गुड्स इफ यू केयर फॉर द नेशन। I think so. The same we are spreading the message right now also to keep our economy intact and to have development in our economy. Use Indian goods, right? Many a times it is seen on the social medias, right? So even it started before independence and still we are dealing with it. We can say advertisement and an appeal to patriotism were combined to promote Swadeshi. So this was all done to sell the product. Why is advertisement then done? To sell the product. And along with the products, this also passed the message of patriotism. So both the they had two intentions behind doing this, selling the products with the national symbols, okay. What was the significance of using historic figures? Historic figures like those were being used by the Britishers. I would like to know what are historic figures. Yes, maybe no, it is like great people like Shivaji Maharaj, Maharana Pratap, right? Lakshmi Mata. Again, that is a god, right? Yes, Bharat Mata, you can say, and we saw all these historic pictures were put up. Okay. So that... what was the significance of this historic figures and the numerous Indian gods of the on the products? Explain. So let us see the answer. It is for 3 marks. What points will you cover in this answer? So the Indian gods and goddesses image. So Kartika, Lakshmi, Saraswati shown on imported cloth labels approving quality of marketed product. This association lent a divine approval to the goods being sold. Foreign manufactured goods appear familiar due to these Indian images. So what was the intention behind that has been said in this? Why Indian god and goddesses were put up, the images were put up on the products. Just a minute, ma'am. Just a minute. Shubham is saying something. But why did the import department took the goods? There was no such import department as such that time. Think about before independence, in nearly by the end of 18th century or something like that, or beginning of 19th century, we can see. Historic figures were used to create respect for the product. The message often seemed to say, if you respect the royal figure, then respect this product. When the product was being used by kings or produced by royal command, its quality would not be questioned. So many things were there behind putting a historic figures, okay, on the product. So next is describe 5 techniques. Adopted by the Manchester industrialist to sell their goods in India. So as you know that they were banned and they tried using different techniques to promote Manchester products. Okay, so what were they? British manufacturers attempted to take over Indian market by adopting different ways, more importantly with the help of advertisement. So like the poor people, they used to sell their products to the British, and the label was put by the Britishers on the local products. This was also being done at instances, not always, at sometimes even this was seen in the market then. Okay, so they overtook the market. They only brought, like, in some markets, even this can mean that in some markets the Indian products were not allowed to sell in a particular market. Only the foreign goods were sold in a particular market. Okay, like we have custom markets nowadays. So whatever is being imported, that only is sold there, right? Imported products are seen in the custom markets even today. Few shops are also there which sell the imported products only. So at that time, such markets did exist at some places. Manchester Industrialist sold cloth in India with Made in Manchester label, which inspired confidence. That means it is of high quality, good quality. Okay, so for that, the label has been put like Made in Manchester. Images of Indian gods, goddesses, and important personalities on label made foreign goods appealing for Indians. Calendars were used as marketing material since they were used across all strata of society. Now, here all strata of society means the literate as well as illiterate people, to convey the message of explaining or reflecting that it's a Indian product or it's a local product. So to propagate this idea, things like images were put up of Indian gods, and even the calendars were used so that everyone can know about the product. Indian manufacturers suggested, if you care for the nation, then buy Indian products through their ads. Advertisement became a vehicle of the message of Swadeshi. Okay, so these are the points what you can include in the answer. Can we have a next slide? Yeah. So you need to begin from the page. Now, markets, what is the name of this PPT? You have to start reading from that. Okay, markets for goods. You have to start from that session till the end of the lesson. Okay.
If you like our videos, do share them and subscribe to our channel. If you want awesome quizzes, write to us. Keep watching and keep learning with Walnut.